Hello everyone. Today in this lesson we are going to deal with angular velocity and linear velocity, and also we'll be dealing with the relation between angular velocity and the linear velocity. So first of all, as we already learned about what is the linear velocity. Linear velocity v is equal to dx divided by dt, or if you are writing in vector notation, velocity vector is equal to dx vector divided by dt. That means rate of change of the displacement, linear displacement, is called what? The linear velocity. Where, what is meant by angular velocity? Angular velocity, in order to explain, just imagine this is the point O and one particle is now rotating about this point O. Okay, so this is the initial position of this particle, say it as P, and after some time now it is rotating about the point O. Now just imagine this is the final position. If you draw the position vector, O to P is the initial position vector and O to P dash is the final position vector. Correct? Now P, P dash is the actual path covered by the object. Delta theta is the angle traced by the revolving particle. Okay? So what is explaining here? When particle is now moving from or rotating from the point P to P dash about the point O, and the angle traced by the body is delta theta in time delta t. So angular velocity we can represent it as omega. Omega is equal to delta theta divided by delta t. Delta theta divided by delta t. That means the rate of change of angular displacement. Rate of change of angular displacement, and that is called word omega. Okay, so here we have discussed here rate of change of displacement, linear displacement, and here angular velocity means what? Rate of change of angular displacement. Now you just imagine the delta t is now tends to zero. Okay, the delta t tends to zero, what is the omega become? We can write here omega is equal to limit delta t tends to zero delta theta divided by delta t, can be written as d theta divided by dt. D theta divided by dt. So what is the angular velocity mean? Omega is equal to d theta divided by dt. Where what is meant by linear velocity? Linear velocity v is equal to dx divided by dt. So this is talking about both angular velocity and linear velocity. Now SI unit of linear velocity is meter per second, whereas the unit of angular velocity is rad per second. Okay, now let's discuss about the relation between angular velocity and the linear velocity. Just to consider an example, okay, a body, say this is an irregular shaped body, okay, an irregular shaped body is now rotating. Rotating means there must be an axis, right? So just imagine the axis is now passing through the object itself. Say this is the z axis, okay. Now just to consider this is the x axis, and there will be one more axis, that is the y axis. Okay, so when this body is now rotate about this z axis, okay, there are so many particles are there in this system. This body can be considered as a system. There are so many particles are there. We are considering just one particle in this system. When the body is rotate, this particle will also rotate, right? So when this particle is rotating, we can say here the particle will rotate about this fixed axis, about this fixed axis. So what is the linear velocity at this point P? Say it as this point is P. Maybe after some time it will reach, the particle will reach here at the point P dash. If I am drawing the position vector from the axis of rotation, this is the position vector towards initial, and this is the final position. Both are same because the r, radius r vector, correct? Now P, P dash is the actual path covered by the particle. Okay, so what we have considered here? A system of particle or a body, and we are considering only one particle is now revolving around the fixed axis. The fixed axis is passing through the z axis. So what is the linear velocity in this case? Linear velocity at the point P, you can draw a tangent, that will be the direction of linear velocity. okay, linear velocity. Now, what is the angle traced by the particle from P to P dash? That you can mark it as delta theta. Delta theta. So in this case, what you have to remember here, rigid body is rotating about the z-axis. All the particle except the particle on the axis of rotation rotate with the same angular velocity. Consider that point. What is that? There are so many particles are there in the system. All these particles are now rotating about the fixed axis. Correct? All these particles will possess same angular velocity, but the linear velocities are different. So in this case, you have to remember one thing here. The angular velocity omega for all particles rotating about the fixed axis, z-axis, is same, where the linear velocity for all the particles are different. If you consider all the particle, the radius are different for each and every particle, right? Maybe r1, r2, r3, etc. So linear velocities are different. Now let's use the formula for angular velocity. Omega is equal to delta theta divided by delta t. This is the equation we have already discussed about, correct? But as we already learned one formula for plane angle, we have learned that one. Plane angle is equal to arc length divided by radius. Arc length divided by radius. So look at the picture here. P to P dash, what is the angle? The angle is equal to delta theta. That's a plane angle. Delta theta is equal to, what is the arc length here? Arc length, you can write here, arc P P dash, right? Divided by the radius vector. What is the radius vector here? And for that particle, that is a r. Now what is P P dash? PP dash means the actual path covered. We can write the speed into time. How much time it is taking? The delta t. So PP dash we can write here, the speed into delta t, that is the PP dash, the actual path. So we can write the formula here, delta theta is equal to, what is PP dash now? That is V into delta t divided by r. So delta theta is equal to V delta t divided by r. This is equation number 2. Now compare the equation number 1 and 2. So from the equation number 1, we can write here omega is equal to, what is delta theta now? V delta t divided by r divided by delta t, right? Delta t cancel. So we got the equation here, omega is equal to V by r, or V is equal to R omega, or V is equal to omega R. This is the relation connecting linear velocity and angular velocity, and this equation represents what? Only the magnitude. Only the magnitude. So how you can represent in terms of vector notation? So let's discuss about the vector notation of the linear velocity and angular velocity. So we can write this equation in terms of vector notation like this. V vector is equal to omega vector cross r vector. Now V vector is equal to omega cross r. This is same as what? A cross B, right? What is A cross B? AB sine theta. So we can write this equation as V is equal to omega r sine theta. Omega r sine theta. Here theta will be always 90 degree. Okay, what is theta here? Theta is the angle between angular velocity and the radius vector, right? And that will be always 90 degree in this case. So what we can write here as a magnitude? V is equal to omega r, or V is equal to r omega. So theta will be always 90 degree. Now how we can say that always the theta is 90 degree? So let's discuss one case here. Okay, just imagine this is the three axis. This is the y axis, and this is the x axis, and maybe this is the z axis. So this is the z axis. Consider one particle. Okay, consider one particle is now rotating about a fixed axis. So we are considering the z is the fixed axis. Okay, so just to consider this object or this particle is now rotating about the fixed axis, about the z axis. Okay, imagine the body is now rotating in anti-clockwise direction. If the object is going in anti-clockwise direction, what is the direction of linear velocity? Linear velocity direction will be always tangent to that point. So this is the direction for linear velocity direction. Okay. Now, what is the radius vector? Radius vector we have already know from the fixed axis to the point P where the particle is situated. So this is the radius vector and this is the linear velocity vector. In this case, the direction of angular velocity will be perpendicular to the plane containing V and R. So you can draw here, this is the direction of omega. Direction of omega is what? Perpendicular to the plane containing the velocity vector and the radius vector. You can see from the picture, this radius vector and the velocity vector are in xy plane. R and V are in xy plane where the omega is perpendicular to that xy plane. Just imagine you are now extending this radius vector. Okay, just extend this radius vector. Now you can see this is the radius vector. Now the angle between omega and R vector, you can see the angle between omega and R vector is always 90 degree. Now how we can find the direction of the omega, or how we can find the direction of the linear velocity? Now let's use the two methods we have already learned to find the direction, right? One is the right hand thumb rule, other one is the screw rule. So let's use the right hand thumb rule. We have already know this formula, V vector is equal to omega cross R vector, same as what? A cross B. That means now use your finger, or now use your right hand and curl your fingers from omega to R vector. Okay, omega to R, that is, this is the case, omega to R, if you curl your fingers, what is the direction of thumb represents? The direction of thumb represents in the direction of velocity vector. So you can see in the picture here, when the particle is now moving in anti-clockwise direction, okay, the linear velocity and the radius vector which lies in the xy plane, then the direction of omega will be perpendicular to that plane containing radius vector and the velocity vector. Clear? So in this case, what is the direction of omega? Direction of omega will be perpendicular. Direction of omega will be perpendicular, that is upward direction. So this is the direction of omega. Okay. Now you just imagine another example. Okay. Consider another example. Same case here, but the particle is now not moving anti-clockwise. Just imagine the particle is moving in clockwise direction. So this is once again the diagram. The object is now moving in an clockwise direction. Okay. Clockwise direction. Once again, if it is moving in clockwise direction, what is the direction of linear velocity? Tangential, right? And this is in the xy plane. Consider that V vector is in the xy plane. In this plane, it is consist of. Okay. Now, what is the position vector? This is the position vector, say it as R vector. Once again, if you extend this one, you can see this is the R vector and this is the V vector. Correct? So in this case, the direction of angular velocity will be, okay, the direction of angular velocity will be perpendicular to the xy plane, because in the xy plane, the velocity vector is the, as well as the radius vector is the. So what is the direction of omega? The direction of omega will be perpendicular to the xy plane, that you can see here downward. So this is the direction of omega. Once again, you can use your right hand thumb rule. Use your right hand thumb rule and curl your fingers from omega to R. This is the way, omega to R. If you rotate your finger from omega to R, you can see here the thumb represents the direction of linear velocity. The thumb represents the direction of linear velocity. Here also, the angle between the radius vector and the angular velocity will be 90 degree. So this is the way. Now what is the main difference here? This is anti-clockwise direction. The particle is moving, and here this is moving in clockwise direction. So what is the basic formula? V is equal to omega cross r. If you write the formula V is equal to r cross omega, that is the wrong equation. So don't use this one. Magnitude wise you can write V is equal to r omega or V is equal to omega r, no problem. But if you are writing in vector notation, the equation must be what? V is equal to omega cross r. So this is talking about what? Vector notation of linear velocity and angular velocity. Okay, so now let's discuss about the angular acceleration. Angular acceleration, just before that, as you already know what is meant by linear acceleration, right? Acceleration is the dv divided by dt. That means rate of change of linear velocity is called a linear acceleration. Now we are talking about the angular acceleration. We used to represent the alpha. Okay, so we can write here alpha is equal to, instead of v, we will be writing here angular velocity d omega divided by dt. This is a vector quantity, so we can write here in vector notation alpha is equal to d omega divided by dt. Okay, now if the axis is fixed, okay, if the axis is fixed, omega will be acting along the axis, right? Omega will be acting along the axis. So what is equation become? Alpha is equal to d omega divided by dt. It become now a scalar quantity. So we can write here word alpha is equal to d omega divided by dt. That means if the axis is fixed axis, not a changing one, always the axis is fixed. So we can write the alpha in terms of a scalar quantity, that is equal to d omega divided by dt. Now what is the SI unit here? Rad per second square. Rad per second square, and if you write the dimension, the equation become t to the power minus 2. So this is called what? Angular acceleration. I hope you understood this one. Thank you all of you.